You are welcome again to this moment of truth coming all the way from the online service of True Believers Baptist Church. I know you are here to meet with God, and as you have come to meet with the Lord God Almighty, God Himself will bless you richly in Jesus' name. And today we shall continue on our topic on the teachings of Jesus Christ. And the other time we talked about the teachings of Jesus Christ. And we read from the book of John chapter 3, we read from verse 1, and I think we ended in verse 5, where we talked, Jesus Christ was teaching, talking about how you and I can get to the kingdom of God, or how we cannot get there except we are what? Born again. So today we shall consider further Jesus is teaching on eternal life. Jesus is teaching on what? Eternal life. Father, we pray today that your word is coming forth unto us. We ask that you grant us the understanding and your children all over the world, those online here, those present physically here, and all those who come across the message in the future. We ask in the name of Jesus that you bless us all. And Lord, we shall go home today. And we shall leave this broadcast today, or this internet connection today, or this YouTube, whatever, where your children are going to watch this. They shall leave this place today, and we all, oh God, shall be blessed, and we shall desire eternal life in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Speak, oh God, for we, your children, we are ready to listen, and we are ready to follow you on to grant us eternal life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Alright, so look at John chapter 3, talking about Jesus' teaching on eternal life. He says, from verse 6, I'll continue what Jesus Christ said to Nicodemus. He said, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. He said, marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it cometh, and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the spirit. In other words, trying to say that spiritual, to be born again is a spiritual thing we are talking about. It's a spiritual thing. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be? Jesus said in verse 10, Jesus answered and said unto him, art thou a master of Israel, knowest not these things? Verse 11 says, very verily I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you of heavenly things? Now, hear what Jesus Christ is trying to explain now. And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Verse 16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. The world through him what? Might be saved. Although I'm going to stop in verse 16. So let's leave the other verse for next week by the grace of God. But from verse 16, we're going to end here. So the conversation of Jesus with Nicodemus continued. And Nicodemus wanted to know more. After Jesus Christ explained to him what it means to be born again, Nicodemus wanted to know. He said, how can this be? How can this be? And then Jesus Christ tried to enlighten him. Jesus Christ tried to make him to understand furthermore that the born again message I'm trying to pass across to you, it doesn't end there. Okay, now for you to be born again, you need to do something. You need to take a step further, and that step further, it means you need to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. But before you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior in our own generation, and now in the time of Jesus Christ, all they need to do is to believe in him. To believe God sent him into the world. That's why he said in verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So what went further to Nicodemus was asking, how can, look at the verse 9, Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be? How is it possible? How can I be born again? You say, I can't see the kingdom of God, I can't enter the kingdom of God, born again. What this issue of born again, what are you talking about? And Jesus Christ was further to say that you need to believe in me, the Son of Man, the Son of God, God, Son of the world, and send his only begotten Son. You need to believe in the Son of God. But in our own generation, so at that time that Jesus Christ was explaining to Nicodemus, he was trying to tell him just that disciples who believe that God sent him. But he went further to say, and that applies to you and I. He went further to say in verse 14, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. What are you talking about? Simple. When the children of Israel sinned against God in Exodus, in the book of Exodus, when they sinned against God, when they were in the wilderness, God sent snake to bite them. And snake came from nowhere. Snake started pouring into the camp of the Israelites and were biting, and the snakes were biting them. And you know, snake cannot bite immediately, you die. And as they were bitten by this snake, you know, after some time, the poison will be going before you know, the person will be forming, and before you know, the person will die. Some of them died. But along the line, they now run to Moses, and they said to Moses, say, Moses, 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 we are beating a snake everywhere, Moses, because you have sinned against God. Please, so ask God to forgive us. Moses went back to God and said, God, what do I do? How do I send these snakes away? And God told Moses, he said, Moses should mold something like a snake in a stick. Should tie a snake, should mold a snake, the shape of a snake on a stick. And then should put the stick in the middle of the field or wherever God asked him to put the stick. Place the stick there with the snake standing on it, so that anyone that looks up to that calf snake, that golden snake or bronze snake that Moses placed up there, as they look, when a snake comes and beats them, as they look up, the poison will have no effect upon them. And as they're going to look up, as all of them are going to look up on that snake, as they look up upon that snake on the wood, the snakes, the poison will not affect them, and before you know it, all your snake will be gone. When they discover that, they bite this one, it's not dying. They bite that one, not dying. Bite this one, their venom is not working again. What will they do? They'll start going, because the snake were sent to kill. But when they discover that they are not killing again, they'll do what? It's not, our mission is done. No, there's another snake standing there. He's telling us to go. So the old snake, they all disappeared. So Jesus Christ was saying that, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. That was to say that what? Jesus hung on the cross. As Jesus hung on the cross, as you lift up your eyes and look upon Jesus, and you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, is the one God sent into this world to die for you and I, and you believe that is the one that died, and not only that, when he died on that cross, as you raise up your head in that cross, when he died, people are wondering, is it over? Is it over? And the Bible says on the third day, he did what? He was buried. And on the third day, he rose again to the newness of life. So that whoever believe in him, we have what? Eternal life. It says that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. So as you look unto Jesus, the book of Hebrews says, looking unto Jesus with the author and finisher of our faith. Looking unto Jesus. And how can you look unto Jesus? You need to look away from your sin. You need to believe that Jesus Christ is able to take away that sin from you. You need to dedicate your heart unto the Lord Jesus. You need to say to Lord Jesus, I am here. I'm a sinner. Please forgive me my sins. Forgive me my sins. Look up and raise up your head. Lift up your eyes. Look into the heavens. And look unto Jesus. Imagining him on the cross. Dying for you. And when he died, it didn't end there. He was buried. And on the third day, he rose up again. So Jesus Christ says, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. And he went for that to explain. And for God loved the world so much, that is why he gave his only begotten Son Jesus. That is why he allowed him to die on the cross. He gave him to us as a special gift. He gave him so that he would die. The death you are supposed to die. Now listen. The death that the Israelites were supposed to die by that snake. By the snake that was biting them. That snake that God told Moses to put on that staff, on that wood. That snake was draining. In other words, that snake was what? Draining all the venom of what? Of those dangerous snakes. So all the venom of those snakes that are biting the people here and there, that one standing there, just an image. That what God said? If for a purpose, God did not say they should go and bow down to the image. And immediately the work is done, Moses threw away that because it's nothing. God only wanted to show us something. So right from the beginning, you can see that the plan that Jesus Christ was coming to die for you and I has already been prepared. It's a plan that has been from the beginning. God has already assigned that one day, at a specific time, just as this serpent, people are looking onto the serpent and they are saved. They look onto the serpent and they are what? They are saved. They are not dying. Because the serpent is taking all the venom, the poison that the snake is supposed to, that's supposed to kill people. It is the golden serpent, the image of that serpent standing there is taking everything. And when the snake said that nobody is dying, they went away. God has already prepared that Jesus Christ is going to die on the cross. And guess what? As you look upon him, that means you believe he is there to take away your sin. And when you look upon Jesus and you come with him without hiding your sins, not hiding your sins, not going, Lord Jesus, maybe you are having cigarette, you put it in your back, Lord Jesus, you see, you understand me, excuse me, you turn back, you smoke it. And then come again, hey, as I was saying, you don't hide your sin behind you. You go there with all your sins and you look unto him, the author and the finisher of your faith. And you say, Lord Jesus, I surrender all unto you. Take my life. Take my heart. I surrender all. Please forgive me my sins. When you do that, you shall be saved. And in our generation, and you take that first step and you believe that I know you died and I know you are buried and I know on the third day you rose up and up to today you are alive forevermore. I believe in you. The Bible says you will have eternal life. So the question is, how do I have eternal life? You need to be born again and you need to believe Jesus died for you. Whosoever believeth in him, you are not going to perish, but you will have eternal life. And in the book of John, chapter 17, the one we are always, people have always referred as the specific prayer of Jesus. Jesus Christ said, John chapter 17, verse 3, he says, and this is eternal life. This is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Knowing Jesus, that God has sent, when you know Jesus, you will know that he is God. When you know Jesus, and you know that Jesus was the one God sent to deliver you and I from our sins, and you believe in this Jesus, you shall have eternal life. You shall eternal life and everlasting life, they are the same thing. Eternal means everlasting. Everlasting means eternal. So don't confuse. They are the same word. That verse, the other verse, verse 15 talk about eternal life, and verse 16 talk about everlasting life. It's talking about the same thing. So I want you to understand that. So if you believe in Jesus, you will have eternal life. And if you believe and you know Jesus, by knowing Jesus means by surrendering unto him, knowing that he was the one God sent to die for you, to take away your sin. As you know and you trust and you believe in him, you will have eternal life. And eternal life is the life you will live, not just here on earth, but when you die, you will live with Jesus forever and ever. If you don't believe that, read on. We shall continue that by the grace of God next week. We will not see that aspect. What of those who don't believe? What of those who refuse to look unto Jesus? What of those who want to doubt that he is the Son of God? What of those who don't believe that it's God? Jesus Christ says, and this is life eternal, that they may know you, God, and Jesus, whom thou sent. You want eternal life. You need to be born again. To be born again means to surrender to Jesus. To believe in him. Are you willing to have eternal life? Eternal life. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. Eternal life. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. Do you want to live eternal life? For God so loved the world, including you listening to me right now, you that have not surrendered to Jesus, for God so loved the world that he gave up his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Do you want that everlasting life? Do you want that eternal life? Then you need to believe in Jesus. Bow your heads as we pray together and take this song. Eternal life. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. I want to live eternal life. God save my soul. Oh my Savior. When you come to collect your people, remember me, O Lord. When you come to collect your people, remember me, O Lord. Amen. If you have not surrendered your life to Jesus, repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I look unto you this moment. And I come to you this moment with all my sins. Today, I surrender my life unto you. And I place my sin upon the cross. Please forgive me my sins. I am a very bad person. I am a wicked person. But I believe you came and you died for my sins. Please forgive me. Today, I want to be born again. And that's why I declare today that you are my Lord. I declare today that you are my Savior. I believe in you. And I surrender my life unto you. I believe you came. You died for me. You were buried. And you rose up the third day to give me victory and to perfect my eternity. I want to live eternal life. Please save my soul. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Lord, I thank you for your children. Wherever they are who have confessed this confession today, help them save their souls. And Lord, I pray that their life will never remain the same again. The next order is for them to attend a Bible-believing church. Please help them to attend a Bible-believing church. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the message of today also. Thank you for your children who have heard. And those, oh God, who have rededicated their lives unto you as the message was going on. And as we are praying this sinner's prayer, and they are saying, God, please forgive me. I know I have not done enough. Lord, please forgive them. And help them, Lord, that they will take you seriously the remaining part of their lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for hearing and answering our prayers. Because we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen.